Hi guys, the following video will highlight for you some of the aspects about a GreenLight Laser prostatectomy. This is in keeping with our current series, which is looking at a variety of different aspects with regards to BPH, or the benign prostatic enlargement that affects men as they progress through life. We do have a video that looks at the pathophysiology, or the development of BPH, and how this presents in men as they get older. We also have a video looking at medical therapy and one looking at some of the minimally invasive treatments, including UroLift or Rezum. Hi, my name is Dr. Charles Chabert. I'm a urologist and director of the prostate clinic. A GreenLight laser, in effect, aims to produce the same end result as a TURP in that it creates a cavity within the prostate to unobstruct the bladder. In essence, it delivers heat in a focused way to the prostate. It liberates prostate tissue and turns it from solid through to gas, and we create a large open cavity inside the prostate in a more bloodless field than is achieved with a TURP. I'm going to have a look now at an animation. GreenLight laser surgery is performed in hospital under a general anesthetic. A telescopic camera is inserted through the urethra to allow direct visualization of the enlarged prostate. Through the center of the telescopic camera, a very fine laser fiber is then inserted. It's this fiber that allows the delivery of the laser energy to the surface of the prostate. The wavelength of the laser is 532 nanometers. It is an efficient way to transfer energy from the laser console through to the surface of the prostate. The energy is absorbed by prostate tissue, vaporizing the tissue, turning from solid to gas. This process is repeated throughout the central part of the prostate, removing the majority of the transition zone. This allows unobstruction of the bladder and improved emptying of an obstructed system. GreenLight laser surgery in my practice is performed here at Pindara Private Hospital. Men are admitted usually overnight with a catheter in place, which is then removed on the first morning post-operatively. But the expectation is that within a few days they have a big improvement in their urinary flow and their bladder-related symptoms slowly, gradually settle down with time. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and switch on your notifications so that you stay up to date with our latest videos regarding all things men's health. Thanks again.